What does a house cleaner eat in order to maintain energy throughout the course of the entire day? It's a great question. We're going to talk about it today. Hi there, I'm Angela Brown, and this is Ask a House Cleaner. This is a show where you get to ask a house cleaning question, and I get to help you find an answer. Now, if you are new to the show, welcome. I'm super glad that you joined us. I recommend that you subscribe. We are here for 5 days a week, and we answer your house cleaning questions and questions about growing your cleaning business. All right, so we have a house cleaner that wrote into the show. You can write into the show, you can call into the show, you can participate even in the show notes below. So participate, jump in on the conversation. You get out of it what you put into it. So we want you to participate. This is a show for you. All right, so a house cleaner wrote into the show and she wanted to know, how do you maintain physical fitness and health, and what do you eat during the course of the day in order to maintain your energy? All right, now I've been in the house cleaning business almost 3 decades. And so one of the things that is super important for me personally, and I'm going to share with you my personal story, because I'm not a nutritionist and I'm not a health food expert or any of those things. I am a house cleaner, okay? But I am the biggest tool that my business will ever have. And so keeping myself in shape and making sure I have enough energy to get through the day. And sometimes if you wear a Fitbit, you will do anywhere from 20 to 40,000 steps in the course of a day cleaning houses, okay? So there's a lot of movement, but you need to be able to maintain that. So what does that look like? What do you eat? All right, so for me, and I am a true confession of not loving to cook. I am not a great cook. Now I know how to cook, but I don't cook. And I choose not to cook because it's a colossal waste of my time. I don't eat fancy foods. And I agreed to myself that I would not eat fancy foods, okay? So what I do is I cook one day a month, and I go to Costco and I buy all my foods and vegetables, or I pick them up from the farmer's market. Now there's a Lidl in town, so sometimes I go to Lidl and I buy fresh fruits and vegetables, but I bring them all home and I do one cooking session. And during that one cooking session, I bring out all my crock pots and I cook everything at once, because I have all this food and I have all these carrots and all these potatoes and all these whatever it is that I have. And I cook them all and then I repackage them and I put them inside the freezer. Now I get a lot of questions about this because people want to know what recipes I use and all that stuff. So true confession, and I hate to bust the bubble, there's no recipe, okay? There are no fancy recipes whatsoever. I eat super boring foods, but they're foods that sustain me through the entire day. So what I did is I went through all my cupboards. I got rid of all of the containers that are larger than 8 ounces. And so my typical containers in my kitchen look like this. This is a stack of my containers. They're little tiny cups. These are made by Rubbermaid, and they have just a lid that goes on top of them, and I can fit all kinds of things in here. This is a screw-on lid so it doesn't leak. So I can put soup, I can put vegetables, I can put fruit, whatever I want. This is for a large portion. The smaller portions are 4 ounce size containers. This is a 4 ounce size container. And this is a Glad container. I'll leave links in the show notes so you guys can see these. This is a Glad container with a snap-on lid. Again, it's airtight. I can put this inside a cooler inside my car and it can carry my lunch, but these are the two sizes that I use. So this is a big portion, this is a small portion. Now, the important thing for me is to keep my blood sugar up during the day. So it's an ongoing series of little tiny meals. And I might eat 6 or 7 of these little tiny portion size meals throughout the day. Now this is my lunch for today. I haven't had my lunch yet for today. This is my lunch for today. And as I open this up, these are just green grapes. Now this is not exciting. This is not super duper delicious. It's gonna taste good because they're fresh grapes and they're natural, but there's nothing processed about this. And what I like about this is a great snack or a great meal to take as a house cleaner, because this goes inside a cooler inside your car. You can eat this between houses that you're cleaning. And because it doesn't need to be refrigerated, it's not gonna go bad if it's inside a cooler in your car. And so one of the things that I like about the snacks that I bring is it's whole food. And so it's not gonna melt, it's not gonna disintegrate, it's not gonna go bad in the course of a day inside my car, inside a cooler, okay? So I make lots of smoothies. And the smoothies that I make are made with a little tub just this size of, let's say, blackberries, blueberries, and strawberries. And so if you live on a farm, I grew up on a farm, and we froze lots of our own fresh fruits and vegetables. And so it could be peaches, it could be berries or whatever. And this is the size that I use that goes inside a blender cup with just water. And I don't mix it up with milk because milk does spoil. And so instead of just having flavored water, you get the benefits of having the berries inside, and it gives you a little bit of flavor. It's a little bit of color. It's fun. It's exciting, but that's it. And then I just sip on that throughout the day. And I will take a jug with me inside the customer's house, right on the edge of my cleaning caddy. I put it inside my mop bucket so that I have it with me and it's not mixed with my cleaning chemicals. But I will sip on that throughout the job so that it's just a hit of more natural energy, and it just keeps my blood sugar levels up throughout the job. And so then when I get back to my car, then I will have another snack, and this one, it might be carrots. And so just raw carrots. There's no sauce to dip it in. I'm not real big on seasonings. I'm not real big on sauces, but it just might be carrots. So I have grapes, I have carrots. I might have a smoothie that has berries in it. I have a lovely smoothie that I've been drinking for years. It's a spinach smoothie that has bananas in it. And so I mix my flax seed with that and my protein powder, and it does have a little bit more stuff in it. And that also keeps me going throughout the day. So I might have two smoothies through the course of a day. I probably drink about 6 waters a day, and then lots of little tiny meals. Now, when I do the cooking at my house, it's going to be a lot of whole foods. And so the whole foods, like this is one I just took out of my freezer, and this is nothing but shredded cauliflower. There are no seasonings. It's not cooked. It's 100% raw. We call it cauliflower rice, but I literally take a whole head of cauliflower and I put it inside my food shredder and I shred it up. It grinds it up really fine. And then I put it inside these containers, and this goes inside the freezer. Now in the freezer, and I should make a note about this, the freezer doesn't do well with these little containers because they don't stack well. If you get a whole freezer full of these, they're gonna like topple over and they're gonna roll out, and you open the door and they're gonna hit the ground, and if they're frozen, it will bust the lid open. So what I do, and I've trained all of my customers that also have something similar, we use these great big buckets. This bucket fits on the inside of a shelf inside your freezer. And now I have dozens of customers that use these buckets as well if you don't have a drawer inside your freezer. Now inside the bucket, this is where it gets good, I have a gallon Ziploc bag. And this gallon Ziploc bag has 10 of these little small containers in it. So these 4-ounce containers, I can fit 10 of these inside 1-gallon Ziploc bag. This gallon Ziploc bag has yams in it. And that's all it is, just yams. And so I open a crock pot, I wash the yams, I put the yams in whole, and I let them cook for hours. When they're done cooking, I take off the peels, I mash them up, no salt, no butter, no seasonings, no nothing, and I put them inside these 4-ounce containers. That's a whole entire meal for me. Now they're already cooked, and so if I put this inside my cooler in my car and I go all day, it's gonna have thawed out. And so I can just grab a spoon and I can eat these. They're gonna be room temperature yams. They're pretty tasty. They're not, you know, like a hamburger. They're not like an ice cream cone, but they're sweet. They taste good. They're healthy. They give me natural energy. And there you go, right? So I can fit 10 of them inside a container. I also do the same with raw avocados. So I'm a real big fan of avocados, and they don't always get eaten on time. If you buy these at Costco, you get 5 or 6 in a bundle, and you may not eat them all at once. You can mash them up and freeze them. And so this is a whole container, a whole gallon Ziploc bag of mashed up avocados. Now this is great. This goes on top of, it can go on top of your avocado rice. It can go on top of a salad. You can just eat it raw. So it's completely up to you. And this doesn't require any cooking at all. And so a lot of the stuff that I put together is not necessarily cooked. I also took this out of my freezer, and this is an 8-ounce container of shredded zucchini squash and yellow squash mixed. So I've got one of those grinders that grind it up like spaghetti where they're really long threads. It's kind of fun. And I just put them in here raw, okay? I put them in raw, put the lid on, and then I freeze it. I can put this in the microwave for 1 minute and it thaws it out and it slightly cooks it. Now there will be about half water because there's a lot of natural water in this. And there will be about half, because it really cooks down, about half squash. So I get about 4 ounces of squash when I'm done, and I just drain it and I grab a fork and I eat it. And then I have a color coding system. This is my color coding system. And I have 4 rolls of painter's tape here. And the painter's tape I put on the lids of my containers. If you can see, this is a red sticker, and I just use a pair of scissors and cut it up. It's a red sticker that goes on top of here, and at a quick glance, I can tell the yellow is for breakfast, the green are snacks, the red are for dinner, and then the blue are for lunch. So I can look at this really quick and see what I have prepared for myself for the day. The really cool thing about this particular system is everyone in my house uses it as well. And so they can go to the freezer, they can open up the freezer, they can see that there's an entire bag that has red stickers on them. And they're like, oh, this is my dinner. And so, oh, this is my lunch. Or they'll open up the fridge and they'll see something like my grapes. And they'll say, oh, this is my snack for the day, right? So it makes it really easy for everyone in the house to pack their own breakfast, lunch, and dinner if they're gonna be gone throughout the course of the day. So I really love this system for me. It's not for everyone. This system works for me because I'm not gonna spend a couple of hours a day in the kitchen. I don't have it to give. I'm not interested in giving it. It's not where I wanna spend my time. And so by having all of my meals consolidated by one day a month, what I can do is I can prepare all of this food. And if someone else in my house, and this happens a lot, my husband will come in, he'll say, are you hungry? Yes, I'm hungry. And he'll say, great. So he'll go in and he'll pull out a thing of cooked beans. And we do the beans also in the 4-ounce containers. And so for him, if he was gonna make dinner, he would grab two of these if there were two of us eating. And he would drop them in the microwave for a minute and it would heat them up. And then you can put these on top of, let's say, corn chips. You can put them next to rice or whatever, and you can make a little meal out of mixing two or three of these together. And there are nights we've had nothing but maybe four different kinds of squash. So we'll have like squash goulash is what we call it. And it's just four different kinds of squash. That's it, that's the whole meal. So like I say, it's not fancy, but it's super effective and it's super healthy. One of the things that I like best about this system is my husband and I used to eat a lot of junk food. When we first got married, we ate a lot of junk food and he was quite large. And he decided that for his own personal health, he wanted to lose weight. And so we went on a diet, if you will, and we decided that we would regulate what we ate. And he lost 114 pounds and he's kept it off. And as a process of that, we changed our relationship with food. And this is what we changed to. We changed to a system that was simple, that were more whole foods, and that were easy to fix. Because we found that, like everyone else, we tend to gravitate towards what's easy and already there. So if your freezer is full of little meals, there's more of a tendency for you to grab something and pop it in the microwave and eat it, or to grab an already prepackaged thing of grapes, for example. Grab it and go. It's easier to do that than it is to make something healthy from scratch. Even we don't do that. We don't have that kind of time and energy. And so we wanted to make sure that we always had things to eat in the house that were simple, that were already, and this is where the magic happens, that were already prepackaged for the size that we want to eat. Because we find if we open like a bag of chips or something and we just start eating, we'll eat the whole bag, right? There's nothing to stop us and no one to stop us and no one's watching us. There's no monitoring going on. We'll just eat whatever and we'll eat larger amounts of whatever. So as long as it's prepackaged in the right sizes, it's easy to access and it's ready to go. And like I say, most of our food is pre-cooked here in the squashes and the yams and the beans and all that stuff. It's easy to heat up in the microwave. And so preparing a meal takes like 2 minutes instead of taking 35 minutes or an hour. And so that is what we have done in our household because it has sustained us for the long haul and it has helped my husband keep off the weight. And so we both feel great. We both have the energy that we need through the day. And it's not processed energy where we're eating processed prepackaged foods where it's gonna make you have a quick jolt and then it's gonna crash your system. It gives us steady, sustained energy throughout the course of the day. And that is really important to me with the schedule that I'm on right now. I need sustained energy throughout the entire day. And I know that as a house cleaner, that has sustained me now for several years. So it's with the smoothies and the whole foods and the smaller portions of food eaten regularly throughout the day that is my secret to success. Anyway, so that is my system. I'm sorry to say there are no fancy recipes. I do have a fancy recipe for smoothies, and that's my spinach smoothie with bananas in it, the protein powder, the flaxseed, all that kind of stuff. And I will leave that as a link in the show notes if you want my smoothie recipe. But all the rest of this is pretty much just whole foods, and this is my relationship to food. Alrighty, I hope that helps. If it does, leave your comments in the notes below. Give us a thumbs up if this was helpful. And if you have questions, go ahead and ask your questions in the notes below as well. All right, until then, leave the world a cleaner place than when you found it.